Okay, so let's proceed. Okay, so just a review from the past video. So these are the steps in solving beams when using double integration method. Okay, specifically we do these steps in order to determine the slope and the deflection of the double integration method. And through these equations, slope equation and the deflection equation, you will be able to compute the slope and the deflection respectively at any point on your beam, okay? At any point X, okay? So, here, okay? So, the last time, so I promised that I will be discussing about the moment equation. So, we will have our first example, okay? So, first, we will be, mag-concentrate tayo dito sa last three steps, the construction of moment equation and determining the slope equation and deflection equations. Okay, so these three. So first, the best thing that we can do is to give an example. Okay, so let us start with the easiest example. Let us try with a beam. Okay, so let us say that this beam has a point load of 8 kilonewton located at the center of the beam. Okay, so let us say that this is a simply supported beam. So one should be pinned, the other should be ruler. Okay, so let us say this is 4 meters and this is 4 meters. So therefore we will have three reactions. Let's say this is AY, AX, and then BY. Okay, so this is point A and point B. Somehow, this is a symmetric beam. Okay? Okay, bakit symmetric beam? Because if you cut it into two, they will be in equal length. 4 meters and then 4 meters at the right and the left. Okay? So, technically, AX here will be zero. And then your AY is equal to BY is equal to 1/2 of 8, which is 4 kilonewton. Okay. So therefore, this AY is 4 kilonewton and BY is 4 kilonewton. Okay, so this is just a shortcut. So if your beam is symmetric in nature, okay, so you can already determine the reactions directly. Just divide the reaction into two. Okay? Equal. Okay? So, AY and BY is equal, which is 4 kilonewton. Okay? So, how do we construct the moment equation here? Okay? So, we know. Okay? So, I will use. Okay? So, we know that E, I, D squared Y over DX squared is equal to the moment equation. Okay? Okay, so this closed quantity X doesn't mean hindi to ibig sabihin na nagmultiply yung X kay M. No, hindi siya multiplication. Which means M of X is just the moment equation. In which the variable is X. So we are trying to find, okay? So we are trying to find the deflection or the slope of that beam at any point X, okay, from the left support. So let us say we are trying to find the slope and deflection of the beam 3 meters from the left supports, okay? So this is our first equation. So this is the moment equation. So how do we write this one? Okay, so ang una mong gagawin, okay, since this is 4 kilonewton, it will become 4 times x, okay? 4x. Okay? And then, because it is a point load. And then we have 8 kilonewton. Since it is downward, it will become negative. Negative 8 multiplied by x minus, since it is located 4 meters from left support, so we will diminish it by 4 meters. Okay. And then the rule in moment equation is that the last reaction, okay, the last reaction and the rightmost will be neglected. Okay, so we will not add plus 4 times x minus 8 because the maximum value of x is 8. So, okay, so if we write, we can write it minus 4 times x minus 8, but somehow the x max is 8. So if we if we substitute 8 here, it will become 0. Okay. So just beware of this connotation, this parenthesis. Okay. So anong ibig sabihin ng parenthesis na to? So explain ko, ah. May kaibahan ang parenthesis na to sa parenthesis na to. They are not equal. So when we say itong parenthesis na to, let us say x minus 4. X minus 4 is, if x minus 4, okay, it only denotes that if x minus 4 is less than 0, let us say x is equal to 3, it will become negative 1, take it as 0. Okay, so if x minus 4 is greater than 0, then it will be the normal value. Okay, so it will be x minus 4 also. Okay, so let us say x is 3. So if x is equal to 3, for example, x is equal to 3, so therefore, x minus 4 is negative 1. But somehow, under x minus 4, if this x minus 4 is drawn inside this parenthesis, it will become 0. Or if x, for example, is equal to 5, so x minus 4, so you do it normally if x is greater than 0. So 5 minus 4 is equal to 1, okay? So ganun. So ganito. Kapag lumagpas siya, okay? Kapag less than 0, yung nasa loob ng saknong, automatically 0 siya. Kapag mas malaki sa 0, automatically yung normal na value niya, okay? Yun yung value, okay? So pag 5, for example, 5 minus 4 equals 1, so 1 siya kasi mas malaki sa 0. Pero kapag mas maliit sa 0, let us say 1 ang x is 1, negative 3, so you take it as 0. So ganun. Eh, so therefore, the answer of this parenthesis, when you simplify it, will never be negative. There will never be a negative value. It will always be greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so ganito yung ang ibig sabihin ng saknong na to. Okay, so this is just an example. Okay, so let's proceed. Okay, so yan yung moment equation natin. Yan. So anong gagawin natin? Okay, so ito yung moment equation natin. So this is true or point load. Okay, so paano naman kapag distributed load? Okay, so let us say, meron tayong, distributed load tayo, okay? So, gumuhit tayo ng distributed load dito sa kabila. Okay, same scenario, pero, let us say, 4 kilonewton per meter. And then, this is 8 meter, okay? So, here, since pin din siya, then ruler, okay? Para makita lang natin yung kaibahan. Okay, so, ruler to, okay? So, for example, ruler din to. Ruler, so therefore, since symmetrical naman sila, automatically, itong AX mo is 0, just like here, 0 to, kasi walang horizontal doon natatama sa kanya, yung AY mo is, and BY is equal. So, AX is 0, AY is equal to BY is equal to 4 multiplied by the length. That is a distributed load. So, the 4 kilonewton per meter should be multiplied by length and then divide by 2. Okay, so since this is symmetrical loading, so this is 16 kilonewton. So, this is 16 kilonewton and this is 16. Okay, so how do we write? It's mx. So, EI d squared y dx squared is equal to the m of x. So, how do we do that? Okay, so therefore, it will become, since AY is 16 kilonewton, so it will be 16x. Okay, it will start at x. Okay, so this x, you measured it from the rightmost support. So this is x, x here. Minus, since it start at 0, so it will become 4x squared over 2. Okay, so this will be your, okay, so this will be your moment equation. Okay, so it will be squared, okay? So this is a 1 degree and a 0 degree slope, okay? So maybe meron akong ilalagay na link kung paano about our past lesson dun sa shear and moment equations. So, magagamit din actually dito, okay? So, this is 16x minus 4x squared over 2. So, it will become 16x minus 2x squared. So, this is the moment equation here. Dito, this is the moment equation here. Okay. So, what about the slope equation? So, the slope equation is EI dy over dx is equal to, just integrate this one. So, it will become 2x squared minus 8 times x minus 4 squared over 2 plus c1. So, that is how we do it. And then, this will be, and then this is the, okay, the slope equation, okay. You just divide it by EI and divide it everything here by EI. It will become the slope equation. And this will be the equation for the deflection. So, it will become, you integrate again. Okay? Dito, pag in-integrate mo si M, okay? Pag in-integrate mo si M, makukuha mo si C slope. Kapag in-integrate mo si slope, ang makukuha mo, C deflection, kaya 2x cubed over 3 minus, okay, magiging 8, 2 plus 1 magiging 3, so 8x minus 4 cubed over 6, okay, plus C1x plus C2, okay, so ito, okay, so sorry for the spacing, okay, so maybe ulitin ko para kumasya. Magiging 2x cubed over 3 minus 8 over 6 x minus 4 cubed. Okay? May cube dito. Then C1x plus C2. Yan. And then here, okay, since this is your moment equation, so your EI over dy dx is equivalent to 8x squared minus 2x cubed over 3. plus C1. Okay, so this is your slope equation. And then, integrate mo uli, makukuha mo naman C. Makukuha mo naman si ano? Okay? Makukuha mo si deflection equation. So, magiging 4. Okay? Magiging 8 over 3 x cubed minus magiging over 4 to. So, 2x over 4. 3 times 4 is 12. So, magiging 1 over 6 to. Okay, so it will become 1 over 6 plus C1x plus C2. Okay? So, the next step that we should do is the boundary conditions. Okay? So, nasulat na natin si moment equation, slope equation, and then the deflection equation natin. Okay? So, itong y, yung deflection, itong dy over dx, yung slope. Okay? So, para natin ma-identify. Okay? So, maybe in the next, we will have a next video. Okay? So, i-apply natin yung boundary conditions. Okay? So, more likely, pwede mong i-apply yung boundary conditions at the beginning. Okay? So, dito, since pin at saka ruler ito, anong masasabi nyo? Okay? At supports, kasi pareho silang exterior supports, so therefore, yung y mo dito is 0. Okay? Y is 0. But your dy over dx will never be 0. Okay? So, therefore, you can replace. Okay? So, this is y. Okay? Sorry. So, this should be y. I'm sorry. So, it should be EIY. So, you can apply if x, okay? So, if x is equal to 0, okay? At this point, x is equal to 0. If x is equal to 0, your y should be equal to 0. So, if this is 0, 0, 0, 0, then you will compute the C2. So, the C2 here will become 0. Actually, okay? So, maybe we could write it in another, what? Okay, so here. So, the boundary conditions here is, I hope is clear. Okay? So, here. Okay, so boundary conditions. So, at x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0 since it is leftmost support. And it is exterior support, okay? So, remember the boundary conditions. Kapag nasa support siya, tapos nasa exterior na supports, nasa labas, kasi isang span lang naman to. So, therefore, yung y mo is 0. So, therefore, EIY is 0 at okay? So, magiging, okay, dito natin, i-replace. So, magiging 0 to is equal to 2x cubed, 2, 3, 0 cubed minus 8 over 6, 0 minus 4, okay, kapag mas maliit, okay, 0 minus 4 is supposed to be negative 4, pero since mas maliit siya sa 0, so 0 siya. Okay? So, take it as 0. So, cube plus C1x, C1 is 0, ay x is 0, plus C2. Okay? 0 lahat, 0, 0. So, therefore, C2 is equal to 0. Okay. So, another boundary condition dito at x is equal to 8. Okay? Dito sa leftmost, rightmost support, y is equal to 0. Okay? Yan. So, therefore, anong makukompute natin? So, ang makukompute natin is, okay, so replace, so EI times 8, okay? I know, EIY, zero pa rin kasi yung y natin is zero. Tulad pa rin dito, y is zero, so therefore 2 over 3, 8 cubed minus 8 over 6, 8 minus 4 is 4, so 4 to the power of 3. And then plus C1x, ang x natin dito pala is C8, plus ang C2 natin is 0. So therefore, makompute na natin. Okay, so C1, o since 0 to 0 is equal to 2/3 8 cubed, okay, 64, 1024 over 3, minus 1664, okay, sana hindi ako magkamali, 1664, 32, minus 256 over 3 plus 8C1. Okay, so makompute natin yung C1 mo is automatically is equivalent. Okay, so si C1 mo dito will be equivalent, okay, to 1,000, okay, so 3 to ha, hindi to 5. Baka hindi nyo masyadong makita. So, $7.62, so magiging ano siya. C1 is negative. Okay, so this is non-negative on $7.62. 768 pala. 2.768 over 3. So, 96. Negative 96. Negative 96 over 3 ang sagot. Negative 96 over 3 is negative 32. So, therefore, negative 32 si C1. Okay? So, the next thing we should do is to replace the value of C1 and C2x. Kaya, therefore, magamit mo yung boundary conditions. Okay? So, you can use the step number 3 nung last equation. You can say it to be the last step. Okay? You can take it as the last step or sa initial pa lang is sabihin, ilagay mo na kung ano yung mga boundary conditions na sa ganun kapag nabuo mo na yung slope equation at saka yung deflection equations o through double integration method, agad-agad mo nang makuha, okay? Madali mo lang makuha si C2 saka si C1, okay? So, you just replace these values respectively, okay? And then replace the x is equal to 3. So, therefore, makita mo na yung deflection in terms of a value over EI. Okay? So, paano natin i-replace? Okay, so maybe... Okay? So, ito yon. Tandaan natin, C1 is negative 32 and C2 is equal to 0. Okay, so maybe... Erase muna natin to. Itong pa to. So, ito muna yung isolve natin. So, this is how we do it. So, since, okay, so since, okay, C1 is negative 32, and then C2 is equal to 0, so therefore, EIY is equal to 2x cubed over 3 minus 8 over 6 x minus 4 cube minus 32x. So this is your general formula. Okay. So if x is equal to 3, y is hindi natin alam. So what if yung tinatanong is, ano yung deflection at x equals 3? So, therefore, ganito. EIY is equal to 2. Replace mo lang si x, 3 cubed over 3 minus 8 over 6, 3 minus 4 to the power of cube minus 32 times 3. Okay? So, since 3 minus 4, okay, 3 minus 4 is less than 0, negative 1 siya, so therefore, you take it as 0. Okay? So, ganun lang yan. Kapag ganito yung saknong, okay, kapag mas mababa sa 0, automatically 0 siya. So, kaya walang negative. Okay? So, walang negative na mangyayari na value. So, EIY is equal to 18 minus 96. Okay? So, I hope tama tayo. So, if wala tayong error, so therefore, negative 78 to. So, EIY is in terms of kilonewton, since kilonewton yung gamit natin, kilonewton meter cube. Okay. So, yan yung, okay, deflection natin. So, the deflection is Y is equal to negative 78 over EI kilonewton meter cube. Okay? So, kapag hindi given yung value ni E tsaka ni I, so take it as the value. Okay. So, but somehow, if E and I are given, for example, E is 200,000. Let us say 200,000 megapascals. And then your I is let us say 20 to the 10 cube mm cube. Okay? So, you just replace this value. Pero, kailangan mo maging aware na i-convert mo to sa Newton, tsaka sa mm. So, Newton maging 10 over 3. So, Newton to kilonewton, kilonewton to Newton is 10 to the power of 3. And then, meter to millimeter is 10 to the power of 3 also. So, 10 to the power of 3 times 3 is 10 to the power of 9. So, i-divide mo siya kay 200,000 and then 20 times 10 to the cube. Then, makuha mo na si y. Okay? Since deflection siya, then negative siya, ibig sabihin pababa. Nandito sa baba yung deflection niya. Okay? So, magtaka ka na kung positive yung nakuha mo. Ibig sabihin, nasa iba, itaas yung sagot mo. Okay? So, okay? So, ganyan. So ito yung magiging sagot mo. Okay? So, if you wish to solve this one, okay? So, you can solve the problem. Okay? So, what will be the deflection of your body? Okay? So, yan yung magiging sagot mo. Okay? So, kung ano man yung sagot dito, it will be the deflection. So, I hope meron kayong naintindihan. Okay? So, kayo na lang sumagot dito sa last problem. And in the next, maybe in the next lecture video, okay, so we will have more examples. Okay, so maybe it will be in a slideshow nang sa ganun is makita nyo yung step by step kung paano isolve yung double integration, kung paano mag-solve using double integration method. Okay? So, dito, yung nakuha natin is deflection. Okay? So, yung nakuha natin na C1, i-replace mo lang din dito sa dito, nang sa ganun is makuha mo yung slope equation. Okay? So, I hope meron kayong naintindihan. Okay? So, in order to to extend your learnings, you should practice solving, and then if you wish, I will add more examples, okay, in the next videos.